Hi everybody, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. I'm Colleen Knight. Today I'm going to be showing you the 179 bunkhouse from Wildwood. This guy is done in fiberglass, so it is a platinum edition. Come on inside and I'll show you around. I'm going to start right off right over here. This is your Murphy bed couch combo. The couch is kind of nice to have if it's been raining for a couple hours or a couple days. You can come in, put your bed up, and utilize the couch space. I'm just going to do this real quickly and show you how easy it is. You just pick up from the bottom of the couch and it slides down. It is good to note that there is access to your storage area under there, so that's kind of handy. So you just unhook both sides of this and then lay it down. This is good to look at. This is a super strong platform that they've built on here. It's nice and thick. It's nice and sturdy. The mattress is nice and soft. It's thick. It's more than sufficient for camping. Anybody who sleeps on this should be very comfortable. Right over here, this is just an access window. These shades are super easy to deal with, up and down. They don't bang against the window when it's when you have the wind or the air circulating through here. That's super nice. And that guy will open pretty far too because it is an exit window. Right over here, we have two burners. So this guy will run off your propane. Right below there, this is your heater. So that's your furnace. This furnace is a 10K furnace, so that's nice. Very sufficient for the size of the coach. Should keep you very, very warm. Good-sized basin sink. Lots of room for washing up plastic plates or pans or whatever dishes you have. Over here is the microwave. This will fit a 10-inch dinner plate. Again, definitely big enough for camping. There's room for popcorn and everything like that in there. You have an extra storage right here. Lots of space that would fit plates, cups. Under here, you have a little more storage. There's an access. These are access panels. Behind there, I believe, is your hot water heater. So nice, easy access to that if you need to fiddle with it. Right over here, we have a dinette. This dinette will turn into an extra bed if you needed extra sleeping. Nice, big front window. Super nice view. You put that all the way up. Little phone chargers scattered everywhere, here and there. Lots of space, lots of spots to charge your phone. This little, what looks like handles right here, will actually hold your portable stereo that comes with this unit. It is a Bluetooth ready stereo, and you can take it inside or take it outside, set it on the picnic table. Pretty handy. It's a pretty nice little radio. Right back over here, you have your two super soft teddy bear bunk beds. These are nice and squishy. They're plenty thick enough. They're nice and comfy. And then under there, there's extra storage. That would be a great spot for a small dog kennel if you're bringing your puppies. Right back in here, we have the bathroom. So nice little sink, hot cold access, nice size mirror so that you can see if you're plan on doing hair or makeup, you can. Little storage area underneath the sink. Plenty of space for shampoo, conditioners, towels, washcloths. You've got enough room to squeeze them in there. Good size shower and a nice vent up top. Just a few more things and then we'll wrap it up in here. I did want to mention that each bunk has its own window. That's super nice, especially if you're the person sleeping in the bunk. If there's not a window, sometimes it can be kind of cave-ish. Another thing I wanted to mention was the Coleman air conditioner. This is a 13K air conditioner, more than what you need for the size of this coach. These guys are super, super quiet. They put out more air and the air is colder than what Wildwoods previously had in their campers. So this is kind of an upgrade this year. So that's super nice. And then the last thing I just want to mention is that these lights are all push button. So if you know that you only use two of these lights, you can set them to where just those two will come on when you flip the light switch. We do have the control panel over there that I'd like to zip through real fast. These are the indicator buttons. So you press any one of these and it will tell you how empty or how full the tank is or the battery, whatever one you're trying to do. This is your awning button that will extend or retract your awning, and then your light controls and your water heater controls. If you're wondering if you can pull this unit's dry weight is 3,446 pounds. It has a cargo carrying capacity of 1,402 and its GVWR is a total of 4,865 pounds. So a lot of smaller and regular size SUVs will be able to pull this guy. This right here is your propane tank that runs your refrigerator, your burners, your hot water heater. We also have a nice diamond plate right on the front of that. That will help if rocks are getting kicked up while you're driving. That'll save the front of your coach quite a bit. This guy will also come with one deep cycle marine grade battery for you. Right over here, we have your solar port. So the 179 is pre-wired for portable solar. So if you wanted to purchase a portable solar panel, you just set it out here in the sun, plug it in, and it will trickle charge your battery for you. Super handy. Little bit of a storage here. Right now, we can't really see through it because we have the spare and the spare hookup in there, but it does go all the way to the other side. There's definitely room in there. You can get your lawn chairs and then extra blankets or any outdoor stuff. You could probably squeeze your outside grill in there, too, if you wanted to. Nice size grab assist handle. These are super handy, especially when you're trying to pack or if you have little kids. And with this being a bunkhouse, I'm sure there's going to be little kids involved. So that would be nice for them. Good size window. We mentioned that from inside. This is an outside plug-in. So if you had anything that you wanted to plug in while you're outside, you can just utilize that. It's right there. Super handy. Nice size awning. This is an electric awning. It has LED lights down the inside of it. Looks super nice at nighttime. It is adjustable on each end, so if it's raining, you can pitch it so that the water will run off one side or the other and not collect, so that it can't cause any damage. 15-inch tire, which is good. A lot of campers are still coming with 14s. This is a 15, so that's kind of an upgrade, too. Right under here, we have a little outside prep station. You have a little refrigerator. You have a drawer for all of your grilling utensils. You do have phone charging ports and another plug-in out here if you have something that you wanted to plug in. So nice little handy little space over here. You could also store, you could do all like your outside plates and plasticware and stuff like that, or paper plates or whatever you have. That'd be a good spot for those. Water access. So if you're grilling on this side or doing some form of cooking or whatever, you do have access to your water. A little blue spray hose comes with it as well. So very convenient, super nice. Back here, we have a pre-wire for a backup camera. So if you wanted to purchase a camera from us, you'll save quite a bit in the installation process because all of the wires are basically already in there. So that's good. Nice little feature. This is just your cable satellite plug. Right here we have your dump station, so that's where you would dump your gray and your black tanks. This is your electrical hookup. This is a 30 amp service, which is pretty common for a camper this size. Nice, easy access to your plug. That's pretty cool. Right here is a potable water filling station. This is where you could fill your freshwater tank with your garden hose, or if you wanted to use jug of water, you could use this too, depending on what you're using that water for. Right here is your city water connection. So if you're at the campsite and you have permanent water, you would just plug into here and that will keep your tank filled for you. Hot water heater. Right over here is the other side of that storage. As you can see, without the tire in it, there is a pretty good little space in there. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to listen to me talk about the 179 Wildwood FSX in the fiberglass, so the platinum version of this unit. If you have any questions or comments, please call us at 970-313-4337. You can also email me at Colleen@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to see more, please hit the subscribe button. It's finally nice here in Colorado, so pack your kiddos up and get out there and get camping.